Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Fusion Industry Association. My name is Cyd Cowley. I'm a PhD student studying at the University of York and working at the Culham Centre for Fusion Energy. Today is Friday, the 16th of April, and I'm here to give you your weekly fusion news roundup. Stories today include 1. Nuclear fusion firm hits funding record with plasma breakthrough. 2. UK nuclear fusion firms make progress towards providing clean power. 3. Research confirms ingredient in household cleaner could improve fusion reactions. 4. Compact advanced tokamak concept takes fusion power one step closer to commercial reality. 1. Nuclear fusion firm hits funding record with plasma breakthrough. Now, this first story from Bloomberg covers the private fusion company TAE Technologies, which has been all over the news recently, including in stories from Popular Mechanics, Reuters, and Financial World. TAE Technologies is a company seeking to commercialize proton-boron fusion through what's called a field reverse configuration device. Now, all of these stories cover two particular pieces of news about TAE Technologies, the first of which is that the company recently achieved a plasma temperature of 50 million degrees in their compact reactor called Norman. This achievement of stable and reproducible fusion temperatures is a sign of the excellent progress being made by TAE Technologies, and bodes well for their next big project, the Copernicus Demonstration System. Now, the second piece of news is that TAE Technologies recently raised an additional $280 million as a result of them completing this milestone. As a result, these stories not only mark the technological breakthroughs of TAE Technologies, but the financial momentum behind the company as well. As of this week, the company has raised more than $880 million from a number of different international investors, from Google to the Kuwait Investment Authority. 2. UK nuclear fusion firms make progress towards providing clean power. So speaking of fantastic achievements from private fusion, our next story comes from New Scientist and details two UK-based private fusion companies and their milestones towards achieving clean energy. The two firms talked about in this article are Tokomak Energy and First Light Fusion, two Oxfordshire-based companies that are featured in the news quite extensively. The article highlights the difference between the two scientific approaches of the companies, with First Light Fusion aiming to inertially confine targets using a large electromagnetic gun that shoots shockwaves into fusion fuel pellets, whereas Tokomak Energy aims to use high magnetic field, tight aspect ratio tokamaks. The story highlights that one thing that unites these companies is their very ambitious goals, with both companies aiming to build demonstration prototype reactors in the 2030s. Compare that to generally safer, more slower-moving public projects such as DEMO, which is expected to be built in the 2050s, these two companies certainly have their sights aimed high. So far, though, both companies are progressing quickly, with Tokomak Energy operating its high magnetic field ST40 tokamak, and First Light Fusion having an electromagnetic gun that can fire fusion pellets up to 20 kilometers a second. As for whether each or both of these companies will be able to make a revolution in our electricity supply, well, we'll just have to wait and see. 3. Research confirms ingredient in household cleaner could improve fusion reactions. Now, this article from physics.org is a great technical piece about something called boronization in magnetic fusion devices. Now, boronization refers to the deposition of the chemical element boron onto the inner walls of fusion devices. Now, this layer of boron usually helps to prevent impurities from escaping from the wall. And since impurities can radiate and cool the plasma down, boronization usually helps to make a more efficient, hotter, more well-behaved plasma. This article in particular looks at recent research from the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory into the injection of boron powder into the tokamak D3D in San Diego. This research, which agrees with previous experiments done on the German ASDEX upgrade tokamak, shows that injecting boron powder in this way can make a more efficient, more well-behaved plasma. Injecting boron in this powder form could therefore be an important technique moving forward, either to complement or replace some older boronization techniques, such as glow discharge boronization. Either way, who knew that a chemical found in common household cleaners could be so important on the path to economic fusion? 4. Compact advanced tokamak concept takes fusion one step closer to commercial reality. Now, our final story from Power Magazine covers a new design of a magnetic confinement fusion device called the Compact Advanced Tokamak, or CAT. The design for CAT was proposed by General Atomics, who currently runs the Tokamak D3D in San Diego. Leading off of research performed on so-called advanced tokamaks at D3D, the CAT design focuses on achieving a very high pressure inside the device. This allows researchers to reduce the current inside the machine, which consequently reduces things like turbulent transport and can lead to a more stable plasma. Another benefit of lower plasma currents is that the machine doesn't need as many current drive systems, which can be very large and very expensive. The concept design for CAT was submitted as an 18-page article in the Journal of Nuclear Fusion, if you'd like to check it out. Overall, this CAT reactor represents just another potential pathway for either public or private ventures to pursue economic nuclear fusion. Right, well, that's all the main stories for today, but as always, I have a few bonuses as well. The first bonus I have today is an interview in Innovation Origins with the Italian Minister of Ecological Transition, Roberto Cingolani. In it, he says that the future of Italy's energy transition will be based a lot around hydrogen and nuclear fusion, which is very exciting. And the final bonus for this week is another story on fusion thrusters for space travel. This one in particular is from Popular Mechanics, and it outlines how we could use fusion thrusters to get all the way from Earth past Neptune. And even more than that, we may be able to do it in under 10 years. Now, if there's anything cooler than nuclear fusion on Earth, it's nuclear fusion on spaceships. So I really recommend checking this one out. Right, well, that's all for Fusion News this week. If you enjoyed the content, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and of course, check out our podcast. And as always, if any of the stories covered here are of interest to you, their links will be in the description.